हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम नेहा पांडे अगेन ब्रॉट अ न्यू टॉपिक फॉर यू दैट इज 25 गोल्ड कॉइन्स. स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स अ वंडरफुल स्टोरी. यू कैन से इट्स अ वंडरफुल फोक टेल विच विल make you amazing. You will enjoy this story. So before starting this chapter with a wonderful story, we'll start. I will request you all to subscribe our channel and please like the video and share it as much as possible, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Of course, if you will not press the bell icon, you will not get the latest notification of our videos. So enjoy the story, enjoy the videos, more and more videos by subscribing our channel. So now let's start. Yes, now the story. First, I would like to tell you what is the story. The story is a folk tale. I already told you, folk tales are the stories which are very small, but they give a big message. They tell the students about the right path. What is right? What is wrong? With the help of the stories, students learn what is good for their life, which path is correct to go to move on. So we must read this kind of story. Reading is a very good habit. So I will request to all my students, all my learners, to read more and more books, and especially the children. If you are wasting your time in watching cartoons and all, just make it less and start reading. Nowadays you are at your home, so start reading the books. Books are available on internet also. You can read e-books and you can get more and more knowledge with these stories. Okay, now let's just start the story. This story is a folk tale about a greedy, selfish, rich man. His name was David. He was very rich, but he was very selfish. He is not helping others. He tried to cheat others. Like, always he want to make more and more money. He loads and loads of money, but he is not helping anyone. And for money, he can cheat anyone. He can deceive anyone. And this story is about a poor man who was the worker of David, the rich man, and his daughter, 10 years old girl, Tina. David wanted to cheat both of them. He wanted to play a trick on them, but at the end, he was punished, and the worker and his honesty was praised and rewarded. How? That will come through the story. That we will know when we will read out the story. Now, here from the story, I have pointed out some difficult words and their meanings, because you should know the meanings of the words, then only you can understand the story. So first word is greedy. I think you all know greedy, but still I have pointed out here, but those who don't know, they can understand. Wanting more and more money than you really need. Means what we need afterwards. Like, suppose that we want one chapati and we want for more and more. One is sufficient for me, but I want more. One chocolate is sufficient to have a day. But children want to get more and more chocolate. So that is called greediness. If one is sufficient, we have to take one. If after our need, if we want something, that is greediness. Hesitate. to pause before you do something. Hesitate means like if you are going to do something wrong, okay? So sometimes you stop yourself whether to do, whether not to do. You have to think. Like if you want to ask something from your teacher and you don't want to ask, why? Maybe ma'am will scold me or this, that. So you, that feeling is called hesitate. Don't hesitate. Go with your thinking. That is hesitate. Cheat. I think I told you when I was telling about a story to you. That time I told you cheat. To deceive someone. To play trick somebody, to trick somebody or to act unfair. Like if you, like suppose that if you are doing, if you want to get something and you cannot get it fairly. Means like with fair means you cannot get. So you do it some unfair means. Like if you are asking pencil from your friend, he is not giving you. Then what will you do? Are he is not giving. Let me take out from his box and I will complain to ma'am, then he will give. So that is called playing a trick on somebody. That is called cheating. Okay, now desire, a strong wish to get something, that is desire. Restless, unable to relax, means like if you want to do something, if you lost something and if you want to get it and continuously you are searching for it, that is called restless. You are not relaxing yourself, you are doing the work. That is restless. Worried, thinking that something bad might happen. If you are in problem, you are thinking about the problem, that is called worriedness. All in vain. Doing something all for nothing. Like if you did something, okay, but there is no use of that. That is called all in vain. Suppose that you have done handwriting in your handwriting book, but you did that handwriting in a very hurried manner and writing was not good. Teacher has erased it everything. So that is called all in vain. You did your hard work, you wrote all these things, but teacher erased it. Why? Because the writing was not good. So your all work was gone in all in vain, means all wasted. So do the things properly, immediately, at once. Like I said, immediately take out your copies. What is this? At once, as I said, take out your copies. That is immediately. Screamed, to cried out very loudly in a high voice. I'm giving you such example. Scream, like teacher is not there in the class, then what you have to do? Just crying in that class and the voice is reaching up to the staff room or to the ground. What is that? That is called screamed. Okay. Innocence. The fact of being guilty or a crime. Like if somebody has not done anything, he don't know about the thing. It's called his innocence. Like David's worker. He has not stolen money. But still David was blaming on him. He is not believing on his innocence. He was just honest. Means he was not criminal. He was not guilty. So that is a innocence. And next is obvious. Obvious is quite clear. Obviously you have to write in your English literature copy. I am teaching you a text. That means what? Which copy you have to take out? You have to take out your English literature. So that is obviously, you know, obviously you have to take out your English literature copy. You are asking me which copy we have to take out. That means you have to take out, obviously, quite clear. I am teaching you text. That means you have to take out your English literature copy. That is called obvious. Okay, quite clear that you know already and clearly, easily seen what is has to be done. Okay, now understood everyone? Okay, now let's move to the story. Now here I have given some pictures. The first picture shows you a David. It's a picture of a David. Now I am telling about David. David was, I told you, he was a very rich man. He was very greedy. And he lived in a town. His name is David.
this picture. This is David. Okay. David is a very greedy man. He is a very selfish man. And he was very rich man. And you know, he always eager to collect more and more money by hook or by crook. Anyhow, he has to gather money. And you know, one of his very bad quality was he was not sharing anything with his friends and relatives. And sometimes he was very selfish with his family members even. This type of selfish man he was. One more quality was there. What was that quality? That quality was he was very rich, although he was paying very less to his workers. He's not giving sufficient amount for their wages. He was giving very less amount. They were not paying them properly. He was having very much. So many workers he's having. But he's paying very less to them as their earnings for their livelihood. Now, one day, he kept 50 gold coins in a bag. And he was very happy. He gathered this money and he kept in a bag. That was 50 gold coins. After collecting this 50 gold coins, he was so happy that he had this much of money. Now, he said, I'll keep it in some safe place. But at the same timing, somebody came to meet him in his office. So he forgot to keep the money in his almirah. He kept it somewhere so that he cannot see the bag. And he forgot, and the bag was lost. Now see in this picture, he was searching the money here and there, in and out. He was asking to everyone, where is my bag, where is my bag, here, there, to his family. Then he moved to his family members, he asked to them, where is my bag. Then he reached to his family, friends, relatives, everyone he asked, whether have you seen my 50 gold coins bag? This was very small bag and that 50 gold coins were there. But he didn't get it. He was so worried. After a few days, the girl, 10 years old girl, Tina, she was also working with her father. His father was a worker of David. So sometimes she also used to come to his house for cleaning and all. She came for cleaning. She saw the bag. She got the bag. See, this is the bag. When she got the bag, she thought of, oh, this is the bag for what my master was searching of. She identified and she took out this bag under that almirah and take it to his father. She took it to David. His mother, her master. She gave it to David. And her father said, sir, master, please check this bag whether all 50 gold coins are there or not. He said, okay, I'll see. While counting the bag, he thought that they have given me the money back. Very honest they are. But what I will do with their honesty? I have to play a trick on them and I can gather more money. So what he did, he counted, and while after counting he said, oh, 50 gold coins. So all means in that way only I said, but there was 75 gold coins. The girl got shocked. Oh no, 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 I found this bag, I didn't take out any money from there. She argued, she said, she pleaded, she assured, but master was not ready to listen. David was not ready to listen the thing. He was saying, no, there was 75 gold coins were in the bag. You have stolen. Then now see, father also pleaded. He was asking, sir, believe on me, believe on us. We haven't stolen the money. As we got the bag, we came to you. We have given to you. But he was not ready to listen. As he was playing a trick, he planned in his mind that I have to take out 25 gold coins from them and I will increase my money. So he was not ready. After some time, he said, okay, not to worry. I will take this matter in the court, in front of the judge. Now they both get afraid. They said, no, sir, please don't take me to the court. We are so poor. We are so poor. How we will go? And from where we will give you 25 gold coins? We have not stolen. Please forgive us. Please forgive us. Please leave us. We got only 50 gold coins. But doesn't matter for him. He said, no, we have to go in our court now. Anyhow, they are very poor. They have to go according to his master. Now in fourth picture, you see, they all went in court. In front of judge, they both appeared. They have said their views in front of the judge. David said, I have lost a bag of 75 gold coins. And this girl, Tina, and my worker, they found the bag and they are returning only 50 gold coins to me. They have stolen my 25 gold coins. Then judge asked to them, Tina and her father. They said, sir, we are very poor. We had not stolen the money. We didn't stolen the money. Whatever bag we found out, we have given back to his master. So please forgive us. Please believe on me that I haven't stolen the money. Then judge, and you know, judge was very intelligent. He was known for his intelligence and wittiness. He was the wittiest one. And he was wittiest means wise, very clever, very intelligent. So he was just thinking of what should be there. What is the matter? So for some times he sat on his chair and think about the matter. Afterwards, he started, you see in this picture, afterward, he started asking questions from one another. First, he asked questions, many questions, where you have lost the bag, from where you got the money, how many gold coins were there, where you have kept the bag, and when you got the bag, everything he asked from David. David was replying to the judge. Afterwards, he started asking to the girl. Girl also replied, whatever questions judge asked, she assured that whatever gold coins I asked, I found, I have given back to my master. So all this process is going on, questioning, answering. Afterwards, judge said, okay. Then again, judge realized who is right and who is wrong. He thought of. He said, okay. So now finally I am admitting it that the bag which was lost by Mr. David in that it was 75 gold coins. But the bag what is founded by this girl is having 50 gold coins. And I received the complaint about 50 gold coins. I didn't receive the 75 gold coins back. And complaint also I didn't receive of 75 gold coins. The complaint what is registered that was of 50 gold coins. And if David is saying that the bag what he lost that was having 70 gold coins. So now it is quite clear, it is obviously, it is very clear that the bag which was founded by a girl that was not David's bag. So I am giving this back to the girl and her father. And whenever I am just and just said that I am just declaring it, the bag in future, if a bag of 70 gold coins will be found, that will be of Davis. But as this bag is having 50 gold coins, so this bag belongs to these two people, these two poor people, that is, one is Tina and her father, the poor father. So judge at the last, judge was very glad, very pleased to see the honesty of Tina and her father. And for rewarding their honesty and their truth, he praised and rewarded them by giving them 50 gold coins what Tina had founded in David's house. So in this way, David lost his 50 gold coins as he was going to cheat two poor people. He has lost forever and ever. And due to honesty, due to fair nature, due to truthfulness, Tina and her father rewarded, appreciated and praised by the judge. And as a reward, judge has given 50 gold coins to both of them. So this was the story. Now, what moral we got from this story that we have to see? What is the story about? The greediness and honesty. So what should be the moral? That moral should be, honesty will always be rewarded, while the greedy is mean to be punished. We can say always honesty and truthfulness always be appreciated, always be praised, always be rewarded, and greediness always to be punished. The cleverness, the greediness, the selfishness, these are very bad qualities, and that these qualities always mean to be punished. So this was our story. Now students, come to the activity part. Now I have some questions for you, and you have to give answer on the basis of this story. Who was David? A kind man or a greedy, selfish man? Obviously, greedy, selfish man. Very good. How many gold coins were there in the small bag? 50 gold coins or 75 gold coins? Yes, there were 50 gold coins. What was the name of the girl who founded the bag? Mina or Tina? Yes, Tina is the name. whom did they go for justice? To a judge or to a king? Yes, to a judge.
David never hesitate to dash other to make money.
Fill in the blanks. Yes, David never hesitate to cheat. Yes.
Cheat. Tina was the daughter of one of his
worker.
David decided to play a with his poor worker. What he want to play?
Yes, trick.
The judge was known for his
intelligence. I'm writing here intelligence. Intelligence. The judge was known for his intelligence. Okay, now next one is
identify the speaker. No, you know the story is between some people. So they have some, they said some sentences, some statements they have given. You have to find out, you have to identify the speaker who said this statement, who delivered these statements.
Okay, first one is, are you sure the missing bag had 75 coins? Who asked this?
Yes, the judge. Where are the other coins? You have stolen them. Where are the other gold coins? You have stolen them. Who said this?
David.
Master, please check whether the bag had 50 gold coins. Who said this?
Yes, Tina.
Write the moral of the story. What is the moral of the story? Honesty will always be rewarded.
While greediness is meant to be punished.
Now here some words are there. We have to make sentence. Use these words in a sentence. Greedy. Orally I am asking you. Greedy.
David was a very greedy man. Or David was a greedy man.
Poor.
He paid very less amount to his worker. Or the worker was very poor.
Bad.
The bag had 50 gold coins. Gold is very expensive metal. Or he lost 50 gold coins. David lost 50 gold coins. Good. So this is the exercise. You all go to the chapters properly. Watch the video. Students, it's my request. Again, if you like the video, please like it and share as much as possible. And continue your studies. Be happy and be safe. Thank you.